Hi, I'm George Pearson, and in this Photoshop Elements Remove Background video, I'll show you how to remove the background using the Quick Selection tool and the Refine Edge. So we can go from this to that very quickly and very easily. Okay, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button and, of course, share. Don't forget to subscribe. I do several videos every single week, and if you subscribe, you won't miss out on any of those videos. Also, take a look at my complete training for Photoshop Elements, and there's a link for that right down there at the top of the description. Okay, let's get to it. Here we are back at the basic image. I'll be using this with Photoshop Elements to remove the background back in here. And normally I'd make a quick selection using the lasso tool and use the Refine Edge to refine that. But if the picture allows it, like this one does with a nice, fairly even background, you can also use the Quick Select tool, and you can still use the Refine Edge. Let me show you how that's done. First off, we'll go over here and grab the Quick Selection tool. Now your icon most likely looks like that. That's the magic wand. Just come down to the options down here and click on the top left corner. That's your Quick Selection. There's the size right there. You can make any size you want, but this is a pretty good size. That's the default. It's 43 pixels. And just begin pulling around like this inside of your background area. And again, if it's a nice clean background, it should select that very easily. Now at this point, the problem is that I have the background selected and not the girl and dog. So you need to reverse that selection. And that's easy. Just go up here to Select and come down to Inverse right there. Now the girl and the dog is selected. Notice right here there are a little bit of wispy hairs right in there. We want to make sure those are in our selection and over here too as well. So for those, we can use the Refine Edge, and it's right down here. Click on that. There's a Refine Edge. You can see there's our brush for that, which is set at 35. For this, that's okay. I'll set this to Smart Radius. I'll leave everything else alone. And then just brush right over the edges of the hair. Right along there and right along this side here. And that's really all you need to do. Everything else in the picture looks just fine. That just guarantees we have nice edges on our hair in there as well. Once that's done, come down here where it says Output 2 and change this to New Layer with Layer Mask and choose OK. What that does is it protects our original image down here, so we're not changing the original image. I always like to keep that safe. Now, if I want to change the background in here, I need to, again, protect this one layer. Let me just bring that back up again. If I just change the background right now by using the graphics and background, it would then replace this background with a new background. I don't want to do that. I want to save this, again, just in case as a safety. So where it says background, double click on the name. You get a new layer dialog box that says layer 0 in it. Choose OK. And we've now changed the background to a layer 0. Now, when I add in a new background using the background tool, it's not going to overwrite this one layer. So I can hide that, and we have that now saved again as a safety. Okay, now come down to graphics, bottom right corner down there. I have mine set by type and also set for backgrounds. There are loads and loads and loads of backgrounds in here that you can use. I mean, it just goes way down. Every single version, they add a few more in here. This is version 2019 right now. There's just a gazillion in here. So let's choose one. I'll take this one right here. Click on that and it puts it in. Now if you see a little blue triangle like that in the upper right hand corner, that means that it's still up on their server. It will take a moment to download that. Everything's available, but they only put the ones, you know, the real standard ones inside of Photoshop when you install Photoshop. Anything else will have to be downloaded, but it's a real fast download. But that will require that you have an active internet connection to do that. So see the blue corner? That's all that, that means. Okay, once the background is in, there we go. And you can see right down here how the background is showing through a little bit of hair right down there and a little bit of hair right over here. So we've solved that hair problem by using that Refine Edge tool. And that fixes that. Let's take a look at our layers again. You can see how it has changed the background down here. If I go back to graphics, I'll choose a different background. I'll choose that one. There it is. Let's go back to layers and you'll see how it has now swapped the background out for the other background. Let me show you one more trick in here. If you want to save this background here, so you can go back and forth between different background options, you need to save this background again as a different name. So double click on this, it will give you a new name, it will give you a new layer numbered based upon the layer numbers up here. Whatever is next up, it will give you that number, choose OK. It's now no longer a background. I can hide that, go back to our graphics, let's go back to our first one here, which I kind of like. There it is. Come back down to layers, and now I have both of those in my file. There's the new one, and here's the one I used before, so I can quickly just take a look at those and see which one I like better without having to go back and forth to the background tool. So whenever you want to keep one inside of your file, just double click where it says background, it will give it a new layer number, and you can then put in another new background as well. So there you go. That's a real fast, easy way to change your background. It's going to work great if you have basically solid background. Even with the shadows and so forth in here, it did a good job. So on a good solid background, you can then use that quick selection tool down here and then use the refine edge as well to clean up any tough areas like around the hair. And there we go. If you want to learn a lot more about Photoshop Elements, I mean everything really, make sure you take a look at my complete training course, and there's a link for that right down there in the description. Also, don't forget to hit like and hit share and also hit subscribe so you'll catch all of my YouTube videos.